Hello students, good morning everyone. Today we are continuing our lesson, the story of Palampur. We are at the last topic of our story of Palampur. That is, who will provide the labor? Labor is one of the important factor of production. As we are discussing one by one the factors of production. Land we have discussed. Land is fixed or not. So land is fixed in Palampur. And there are various measures to increase the production in a given piece of land that we have discussed. Next important factor of production, that is labor. Who will provide the labor? As you know that labor means the people who work, or the people themselves are known as the labor, or their work is known as labor. Small farmers, we can see, along with their family members, they cultivate in their own fields. Small farmers, their area of farming is less. So they can, with their own family members, they can work in the field and they can cultivate their own field. But medium and large farmers, they hire farm laborers. So medium and large farmers, they have a lot of area for the cultivation. So what they do, they hire farm laborers for the cultivation. And they give the wages to the farm laborers. These wages can be either in cash or in kind. Kind in the sense in the crop. Suppose they cultivate rice. In rice, they can give that labor charge. Or such type of crop can be given. So it is known as kind. So wages are given either in cash or in kind. This is regarding the medium and large farmers in Palampur. And wages, you could see, if it vary from region to region, crop to crop, or from one farming activity to another farming activity. For example, during sowing season, harvesting season, etc., the wages can be vary. So there are means wages can vary from region to region. From one region to another region, it can vary. From one crop to another crop, some particular different types of crops are produced. So it vary from crop to crop, and also it vary from farming and one farming activity to another farming activity. So these are the important thing that the laborers or the labor regarding the labor factor of production we have to study. Now let us see that the capital is yet another important factor of production. Capital is needed in farming, not only in agriculture. Every areas of production, capital is an essential factor. Capital means the money which we use as investment. That is capital. Modern farming methods, as we have discussed, which need lot of capital. For example, plowing machine, tractor, thresher, tiller, then HPV seeds, fertilizers, pesticides, irrigation techniques or irrigation methods, which need high amount of capital or lot of capital is required for modern farming methods. Most of the small farmers, as we consider the small farmers of Palampur, they borrow from large farmers or village money lenders or traders. Small farmers, they approach the money lenders or traders and they borrow the money. The rate of interest is very high on these loans. So when they borrow this money, the rate of interest they have to pay back, which is very high. And the medium and large farmers have their own savings from the farming. But medium and large farmers, as we see in Palampur, they have a large area to produce. Field is comparatively very large, so their production or harvest is also more, and they get lot of amount of money from this production. So they have an enough saving for the for with them, which can be used for the farming for next season. So they can thus arrange the capital from this surplus savings, or they have enough saving from that, they can arrange the capital which is necessary for the farming activity. So there are two types of people, as we say, small farmers and large farmers. Small farmers have problem in arranging capital, and also labor work. They have their own family members. This we could see. But regarding the medium and large farmers, as we see, that they have enough capital, and also they can appoint or they can hire the laborers from different place in their field. Now let us see, there are many non-farming activities engaged by the people in Palampur. So Palampur people are not only doing farming, but they do various types of employment or non-farming activities. First we could see dairy is one of the important non-farming activity that is means people follow. Dairy means by rearing animals for or buffalo etc. That dairy farming, dairy, and people feed these buffaloes on various grass, especially jowar, bajra etc. They cultivate that hay can be given or the grass can be given to the buffaloes. They get enough milk from these buffaloes, and which is sold in Raiganj, the nearby large village. Raiganj is the nearby large village where they sell it in the Raiganj. And then next, another important non-farming activity in Palampur, as we say, small scale manufacturing. Small scale manufacturing is which involves various types of simple production methods. For example, small scale manufacturing methods in Palampur, as we say, that farmers of sugarcane farmers, they have their own, or sugarcane is one of the important important crop which is cultivated. Many people, they crush the sugarcane, and this so crushing machines they have, and they get the and they this is another important non-farming activities. So this one another, that is manufacturing, small scale manufacturing. In that we see, I have told you that sugarcane crushing is one non-farming activity. Same way as we, there are many non-farming small scale activities. For example, small scale manufacturing activities. For example, we could say matchsticks or agarbattis, production of agarbattis, which or many such activities which can be done in a small room, in our own room in the house, and which needs less investment or less money. So such small scale manufacturing is conducted by the Palampur people. Dal mill, mills are there. Many people have their own mills to give the to crush these grains, dal etc. So such type of activities are also considered as small scale manufacturing activities. Next is we could see shopkeeping. So third important non-farming activities we say shopkeeping. Shopkeeping, as is you know that in our surrounding we could see many shops are conducted by the shopkeepers. Many, there are many shops. So same way, traders of Palampur are the shopkeepers. They buy various goods from the wholesale markets in the cities and sell them in the villages. So such type of small scale shopkeepers are there in Palampur near the bus stand and where the junctions. They have their own shops and they sell various types of things. So that is another non-farming activity. Last, that we could say that transport is another non-farming activities which we have studied in the beginning. Transport means on the Palampur roads we could see there are various types of transport system or vehicles. For example, we have seen bullock carts, bogies, tongas, jeeps etc., truck etc., which are a medium of this traveling, or which is used as for traveling by the Palampur people. So transport is another important non-farming activities of the Palampur people. So particularly non-farming activities in Palampur include dairy, second one small-scale manufacturing, third one shopkeeping and transport. These are the various activities in Palampur. So Palampur is, we could see that it is a well-developed village. Palampur, we can say that it is a well-developed village because it has many reasons we can point out as Palampur as well-developed village. One thing that people not only engage in farming, but they follow various non-farming activities. Next thing, Palampur people, they have most of the houses have electricity connection. Next thing that they follow many modern farming methods in production. As we have discussed, hybrid seeds, HYV seeds, irrigation methods, fertilizers they follow. So, and Palampur also has school, we could see school, primary health center. So we can say that, and a good network of roads. It is connected to Raiganj, a very big village, and Shahapur, a very big town nearby Palampur. And these are the reasons that we can say Palampur is a well-developed village.